Hello, Gordon Pinsent here again. The Humber Valley Bay of Islands area is ripe for development, and the potential has barely been scratched. The nucleus of a well-rounded economy is already present in the Humber Valley Bay of Islands area, and there are obvious directions for growth based on existing businesses. Let's take the agricultural industry as an example. We've talked to Gerard Beaulieu and Rob Garnier of Reedville about their berry industry.
Well, when I started with strawberries in those days, there virtually was no one else at strawberries, and it was a wide open market. As a matter of fact, strawberry industry has grown about 1,000% since I started. I've been at it about 8 years, so it's an absolutely wide open market in those days. It's getting a little more uncomfortable now, but there's still lots of room for expansion.
Well, you look at most of the farmers here, most of them are diversifying now more and more so than they ever did. It was all initially mostly root crop. Now it's getting into dairy and hay production, and some people have both. And so it's the way to go here now. It's like our land base was small, so we really had to get a crop that was going to produce, you know, quite high yields and get a fair value on that yield.
Greg Brooks of Canning, Nova Scotia, a tiny town just outside Wolfville, uses fresh local berries and fruit from the Annapolis Valley area in his gourmet preserves. Greg has perfected his recipes in his own kitchen and has a growing market throughout eastern Canada. Harris Johnson of West Royalty, Prince Edward Island, uses locally grown produce and prepares it for industrial consumption. His plant peels, dices, and packages potatoes, carrots, turnips, and other vegetables, as well as produces a full line of salads for wholesale and retail outlets. Another area where Newfoundland could experience tremendous growth is in secondary dairy processing. George Wells of Cormac has just started a small-scale dairy farm. He says there is potential for a very profitable dairy industry.
I think there's a good living. Once you get established your land base, you get your that is the main thing here, is getting your amount of land, your hay land, pasture land. That is the whole, that's the name of the game. That's your dollars. If you haven't got that, you don't make your dollars.
Elmer McDonald of Hunter River, Prince Edward Island, also began with a small-scale dairy operation, strictly for milk production. However, during the last couple of years, Elmer began some experimentation. Today, he produces milk, ice cream, sour cream, cottage cheese, yogurt, and one of the newer trends in dairy processing, the soft-serve yo-cream. Mr. McDonald uses milk from his own cows and has expanded enough to buy milk from other farmers. His yo cream is sold through vending machines in malls in PEI and on the boardwalks near the island's popular beach area. Mr. McDonald says his product may be sold in other areas of Atlantic Canada if he can keep building his production. Newfoundlanders have had to be very resourceful over the years when trying to clothe themselves for harsh weather. Vernon Northcott of Humber Handicrafts has taken a traditionally styled duffel coat and created a job for herself and several other seamstresses. Verna's coats have become so popular, she's seeking new markets south of the border.
So now what I'm doing is, you know, like I'm looking for markets. Actually, it was only one day last week, a person came from New York and they want to buy my coats for a catalog, you know, order.
If the duffel coat can become a high fashion item in other parts of the country, what about all the creative Newfoundland sewers who make their own home accessories and fashions? Monica Castandi of Truro, Nova Scotia, has a booming business in coordinated home accessories.
We can do complete rooms, whether it's a kitchen or a dining room, or we're even doing complete bedrooms now with curtains, bedspreads, and pillow shams and so on. For the kitchen, we can do appliance covers, aprons, tablecloths, fitted tablecloths, lampshades, oven mitts, appliance covers, in fact, anything that people want.
Patty Palmer grew up on the beaches of Prince Edward Island. As a result, she knew exactly what would look and feel good to wear on hot summer days in Atlantic Canada. Patty has designed a line of summer wear that includes shorts, tops, bathing suits, and sundresses. All practical, all fun to wear, and all made just outside Charlottetown. So far, her designs are sold in PEI, Halifax, Moncton, St. John, and Fredericton. What Patty Palmer is doing in Prince Edward Island can be done in Newfoundland. Pierre Villeneuve of Mermaid Marine Engines of Prince Edward Island is supplying a need right here in Newfoundland. His company takes a standard engine block built in England and reworks it to fit the needs of fishermen in Atlantic Canada. All levels of government have agencies in place to help small business. Some of these agencies can offer funding, planning advice, marketing tools, or a combination of all of these.
The way our system works here is that a person coming in, we set a base rate for rental rates, which takes into account the normal commercial rental rates for the area. And what we've done is sort of came mid-range of those rates. And then we've put in place a formula whereby a business starting off would pay 25% the first 2 years, going to 50% in year three, and 75% in year four. The idea being that after year four, they would have put their markets in place and got their business established, and then they can go build their own building or rent from someone else.
There's a desperate need out there for a place for people to come into. Now, normally, what do? When you start a business, you go in to see your banker, you see your lawyer, or maybe your accountant. Or if you've got a friend who's in business, you ask him about, how do I do this certain thing? So we're trying to say there's got to be a little bit more of a more open door somewhere that people can go. Because sometimes people are inhibited by going into a lawyer. They have no contact with a lawyer, no contact with an accountant. You know, some from just starting out, they don't have that. So we're trying to get our door open so that people can say, all right, let's go into the Newfoundland and Labrador Development Corporation. We're a provincial business. We're not federally funded any longer. We're just strictly provincial business. And we feel we're more adaptable, that we can meet the needs of this thing.
One should, first of all, give some thought to the idea. Develop it to some degree so that as you make your initial contact with my office or any other, that you're able to talk in a fairly concise manner about it starting off. I don't mean that you need to have the idea fully developed, but I mean that you should prepare yourself a little bit. And having done that, then it's simply a matter of calling my office and we'll be glad to assist you in developing your idea further, helping you put together your financing package and your business plan.
Anybody that comes through the door can get guidance as to where they may get help if we can't give it. As you're quite aware, we have the Department of Development and Tourism, the provincial department right next door. We have the Newfoundland and Labrador Development Corporation, and we've downstairs we have the Federal Business Development Bank. And we all work together wherever we can on behalf of the client. So there's no excuse for anybody not getting the information they need, where to go, and so on.
We have a Rural Development Authority Loans Program, and it is designed to provide low-interest loans at preferred rates and favorable terms to encourage small businesses to establish or expand their operations in Newfoundland.
Just how important a role does small business play in our local economy? Let's have some fun with this question. Let's imagine one little chicken. That one chicken, along with several thousand others, provides a living for a chicken farmer in the Humber Valley region. Once that chicken reaches a certain stage of maturity, he is trucked to Newfoundland Farm Products for processing. The trucker earns his livelihood from the truck and its cargo. The employees at Newfoundland Farm Products earn their salary from preparing that chicken for retail outlets. That one chicken is then handled by staff at a grocery store who are paid from the profits made from meat and grocery products. That chicken then provides Sunday dinner for a family either at home or at a restaurant. This one little chicken is just a small example of how businesses in the Humber Valley Bay of Islands area can benefit from each other. The changes in the economy over the past few years are staggering. It is evident that a great deal of development has taken place and will continue to take place in the near future. Small business seems to be the key to Newfoundland's future. And more people are taking the plunge and opening the doors to more businesses. If you think you may have what it takes, if you have a solid idea, then go for it. That's what small business is all about.